Now, in this video, I shall be telling you a story, okay, from the chapter number 2, Understanding Secularism, okay. Now, I hope the earlier concept of why the separation of religion from state is important, how India is a secular state, and how the peoples of India get the freedom on the basis of religion, all these three concepts are clear to you. Okay, now let's move ahead in this video. Government school. So this is a story of a government school. Okay. Now, in a government school in Simapur, students want to celebrate a religious festival. So this school is located in Simapur, and where all the students want to celebrate a religious festival. Now, sir, there is a big religious festival next month. We have never celebrated it in school. Can we do it this year? So here the students are asking from their teachers or seeking their permission to celebrate the religious festival in the school. Now the teacher says, I'm afraid that it isn't possible, Rekha. This is a government school. We cannot give importance to any one religion. Private schools may do that. Government schools don't celebrate any religious festivals in the school premises. Most religious festivals are a public holiday so that we can celebrate these at homes. Okay, so here the teacher says these kind of festival are celebrated in the private institutions, private schools, but not in the government schools. So we have a holiday to celebrate all our religious festivals at home. Okay, now the students are discussing. I never thought of it this way. I guess we can always celebrate it outside schools. Anyway, we were planning to celebrate in our locality. So the students have decided to celebrate that religious festival in their locality or in their society. Okay. Now, in the above story, the celebration of a religious festival within the school would have been a violation of the government's policy for treating all religions equally. Okay. Now, the teacher has equally refused to celebrate one particular function of a religious, of one religions. So it's better to deny that suggestion and promote a government holiday on that particular day, because ye to fir bhai sarkar ke un नियमों की उल्लेखना हो जाएंगी ना, उन भाई नियमों का पालन ना होना हो जाएगा कि भाई सरकार एक तरफ ये कहती है कि सभी धर्म एक समान है, और फिर वो गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स में भी क्या कर रही है कि भाई किसी एक धर्म के फंक्शन को ही सेलिब्रेट कर रही है और बाकियों को नहीं कर रही है. सो इट्स बेटर टू डिसाइड आ हॉलीडे. ओके. The second way in which Indian secularism works to prevent the above domination is through a strategy of non-interference. This means that in order to respect the sentiments of all religions and not interfere with religious practices, that state makes certain exceptions for particular religious communities. Okay. Now, government school often have students from different religious backgrounds. Reread the three objectives of a secular state and write down sentences on why it is important that government schools do not promote any one religion. So this is your homework, and I have already discussed it with you that why it is important that government schools do not promote any one religions. Okay, now this is your homework to find out the answer of this question. Okay, now there is another story, and in this story we shall be discussing about that why we should not interfere into other religions, into other cultures and traditions, other beliefs and custom, and not to make them insecure, inferior within the boundaries of our own nation. Okay, a group of friends who have recently bought scooter are meeting to go for a ride together. दो दोस्तों ने नए स्कूटर लिए हैं और वो एक राइड पे जाना चाहते हैं साथ साथ. ओके, सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस स्टोरी. हे, आई होप Hey, I hope you have a helmet. You know the law in Delhi requires that you wear one. Why aren't you wearing a helmet? Do you want to be fined? Don't worry, I will not be fined. Hey Pramjit, why won't you be fined? 4. Wearing a pagdi is a very important part of our religion. The government cannot force me to wear a helmet. Okay, so now as we all know that the Sikh people wear pagdi, and their pagdi is show their pride, honor, respect and love for their own religion. And the government of institution, the government of India and the Indian constitution has passed several laws for each and every religion in our country to promote their beliefs, to promote their customs in the public places as well. Okay, so नाउ द स्टोरी इज सेइंग दैट कि भाई जो सरदार जी हैं उन्होंने पगड़ी पहन रखी है, हेलमेट क्यों नहीं पहना हुआ? तो सरदार जी कहते हैं कि आप चिंता न करें, आप निश्चिंत रहें, कोई भी मुझे फाइन नहीं लगाएगा बिकॉज मैंने पगड़ी पहन रखी है और मैं हेलमेट नहीं पहन सकता. ओके, so this is also an example where government of India is giving respect and love to all the religions of our country. Okay, now in the above story, Pramjit the Sikh youth does not have to wear a helmet. This is because the Indian state recognizing that wearing a pagdi turban is central to a Sikh religious practice, and in order not to interfere with this, laws and expectations in the law. Okay, so I told you this. The third way in which Indian secularism works to prevent the domination listed earlier is through a strategy of intervention. You read earlier in this chapter about untouchability. This is good example where the member of the same religions, upper caste Hindus, dominate others members, some lower caste within it. In order to prevent this religion based exclusion and discrimination of lower caste, the Indian constitutions man untouchability. In this instance, the state is intervening in religion in order to end a social practice that it believes discriminates and excludes, and that violates the fundamental rights of lower caste who are citizens of this country. Similarly, to ensure that laws relating to equal inheritance rights are respected, the state may have to be intervene in the religion based personal laws of the communities. Okay, so now in India, untouchability is also banned, and it is a term of inequality. Okay, okay, and so there should be no discrimination on the basis of untouchability. Also, like I am senior, he is junior. I belong to a majority class, he belongs to a minority class. I am superior, he is not superior. I belong to a rich family, he belong to a poor family. So such kind of feelings are not to be tolerated among the individuals or into a society. So what's the need that untouchability has been abolished, has been banned in India? Okay, now this is an example of USA. In the United States of America, most children in government schools have to begin their school day reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. This pledge includes the words, "Under God." It was established more than 60 years ago that government school students are not required to recite the pledge if it conflicts with their religious beliefs. Despite this, there have been several legal challenges objecting to the phrase "under God," saying that violates the separation between church and the state that the First Amendment of the US Constitution guarantees. The above photo shows students taking the Pledge of Allegiance in a government schools in the USA. So as we all know that we also have our Vande Mataram song, our national prayers, our national song, and the Pledge of India. Like all the citizens are brother and sister. In the same way, in US also, in the government schools, they start their day with the pledge under God. Okay, so this is also a feeling of freedom, a feeling of respecting our own religion. Okay, I hope till here the chapter is complete to you, and in the next video we shall cover up the chapter. Okay, thank you.